Bodega Boys.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to this press conference. I am here from the CDC, the channel. Bodega Boys people get that reference. Anyway, I got a new press conference. We have new information. I believe, as the West Coast people would say, we've been flocking in the past. We haven't been bringing that heat, that data, that statistical shit that makes you dick hard. So we're going to come out with some new shit from the streets, you know? The CDC is back, bitches. And to announce this, we're going to have Yesenia. She, you know her. She is a recent hire from the Biden Kamala administration. And it's important that, you know, I would just like to point out that, you know, we have a Latino female, Latina, Latinx, Latinx, I don't know. But listen, she's round, she's here. And, you know, she's representing. She's giving them the diversity, you know. So coming up next in her ballerina flats, straight from the two train she got on at Jackson Avenue. Give it up for Surgeon General Yesenia.
Mm-hmm. Yes. That's right. Thank you. Thank you for the introduction. Pardon my tardiness. I was getting ready for some information to give you real information because we're the CDC now and I run this shit. So the new rules is this. Y'all can share hookah, all right? Y'all can share the same mouthpiece, but you gotta lick, like you gotta blow on it. Like if you like when shit falls on the floor, it's like a 5 second rule. That's it. That's like the new guidelines for hookah. And also for the max, like when you wear a max, like if you in an Uber, or something like that, like you have to wear a mask. Also, if you go into the supermarket and the cashier is not wearing a mask, your platanos is free. That's the new guidelines. That's the third guideline. And the fourth guideline, I think, is like if you throw a wild, you cannot throw a wild on top of a wild in Uno. That's also the new guideline. All right? So y'all take that with you. You know what I'm saying? It's very important to have and to understand. And also, y'all need to keep wearing your mask, so stop fucking playing with me. Because I used to have make 3/4 of my yearly income doing bottle service. And y'all fucking the game up, okay? Coming in with no dick and no max, no macarita and bar and shit like that. And y'all wasting time, all right? I'm trying to get back into my nightlife shit, all right? This CDC shit is whack, nigga. I lied on my resume to get this shit. I said I was bilingual, even though I am. But you know, like, I lied about my education and shit like that. But listen, I'm trying to do phlebotomy and bottle waitressing. So please, y'all keep wearing your mask. I know you got your little vaccine, bacunita, your little vaccine. That's good. That's for you, stupid. That's for you don't get sick, stupid. The mask is for other motherfuckers not to get sick, all right? And there's a lot of variations in New York, all right? So y'all gotta chill. I'm trying to go back to La Marina. We're trying to reestablish, restore the feeling, all right? Thank you. I'm the new Attorney General, and also, I would like to say that old motherfucker, Ben Kessie, or whatever the fuck out of here. It's quiet for you, all right? Thank you. Shout out to Joe, shout out to Kamala, everybody that put me on, you feel me? Shout out to the Bronx all day, BX all day, you know? Shout out to all my phlebotomy academies, you know what I'm saying, that got this certificate. Shout out to y'all. We winning, we up, baby, let's go. You know what I'm saying? This is episode 242 of the Most Dangerous Podcast. Do the fucking drop off here, let's go. Attorney General Yesenia in the building.
You're listening to The Audio Art, the most dangerous podcast in the universe. Do the drop.
Episode 242 of the World's Most Dangerous Podcast, coming to you live from the internal struggle inside your body. We decide if you want to get out of bed because it's not even meaningful. Like, there's nothing you literally can do today that's going to change the outcome of the world to protect your kids and your grandkids and their offspring, because you know what? Global warming is coming. If the world goes up in 2 degrees, we're fucked.
Icebergs are melting.
And you're just like, what can I do? What can I possibly do to help alleviate this pain? And all you're doing is what you're doing right now, listening to the most dangerous podcast in the world. Listen to this podcast is like the guy at Pompeii who got covered in ash while he was masturbating.
Checking
That's
off.
What you are. You are a national hero. You was like, yo, bro.
You live in a now.
That volcano's going off? Let me rub one out, bro.
Real quick.
Bro, you know I'm saying? Not the only one Krakatoa, if you know what I mean.
You know what I mean?
Hey, bro. Hey, bro. Hey, bro, that's not lava, bro. Hey,
yo, I'm going to die doing what I love.
Shout out to that guy. That was official.
Beat him on meat.
That was like the first Sucio boy. How? They like, yo, the volcano is erupting. You
yo, move,
leave.
Yo. And your man even have coming in the house.
Your man didn't have Spank Bang. Your man didn't have Porn Addict, if that's a real website. And you know what I'm saying? Your man might have had Tapestry. Your man was whacking it to Tapestry. Yeah. While there was sulfur in the air. You just hear people running and screaming. Have you seen my baby? Have you seen my baby? And then I guess there's the guy. He's like, hats for sale. Hats. No, that's the book from Reading Rainbow. But you get the vibes.
I think it was jerking off to statues.
Yeah. Yeah, bro.
I think it was jerking off to Mona Lisa and shit. Like,
bro.
Ew.
Bro. Like, what's behind that little smirk? Was Mona Lisa the original OnlyFans?
See? Leonardo da Vinci was like, yo, $5.99 a month. You get to come see this shit.
OnlyFans sucked in the Renaissance era because you was like, damn, yo, when Ma updates this in 8 months. Shit's gonna be fire. Yo.
Fire, yo.
Yo, you dirty bitch. Yo, use some oil-based paints next time. Yeah.
Ooh, yeah. Fuck with that. Yeah, I like that style. Yeah. Give me a little Raphael flow. You know what I'm saying? A little Raphael.
Fucking dirty whore. Show me your blue period.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right. I'm like, okay.
As always, this episode of the Bodega Boys podcast is sponsored by the MoMA. The MoMA. A good place to go for a cheap date and do some finger popping while you're watching some weird statues. Be sure to check out the MoMA. They need your help because, you know, because of COVID, they kind of got closed down. And now that they're open, they're like, hey, you know what? We're going to return all the stuff we got from Africa. We couldn't have had it in the first place. And, well, that...
You thought? They're like, you thought, motherfucker? You know how many people come here for this shit?
How did archaeology start? And it was like, finders keepers. They was like, no, nigga, we got to go to court. No, and they were like, find, matter of fact, Salucci. They throw it to someone else.
Yo,
it was like,
no backseat.
No black magic. They was like, oh, shit, we in Africa. And I said, no black magic.
White people will go to fucking Africa, dig up a dinosaur, and be like, yo, this is our shit.
It's like, no.
This no. No, you dug this shit up in Congo. It belongs to Congo, motherfucker.
Oh, God damn.
Why can't they have nice things, motherfucker? The first Tyrannosaurus Rex was not found in motherfucking 81st Street. I'll tell you that much. I know that.
I mean, if you know where to look,
bro. My teacher's lying.
Back when New York was rough, I mean, I knew a dinosaur that used to sell cock. That's what we used to call pussy back in 83, bro. And, you know. I remember, because I was confused, because I was like, you selling cock? And they was like, for who? And I was like, my friend Herbie. And they was like, who? And I was like, Herbie Hancock. And they was like, Herbie Hancock wants cock? And I was like, Herbie Hancock wants cock. You seen his videos. He got fucking robot legs dangling from the roof. He's wild. He's on some fucking new drugs. Like, just go with him, huh?
Yo. Niggas are the two. Niggas are dinosaurs. Niggas is fucking dinosaurs now. The B in BC stands for fucking brontosaurus. Like,
Brontosaurus Church. Yeah,
Brontosaurus
bro. Yeah, bro.
Damn.
Listen, you don't know how many, if in like the unreleased episodes of the Flintstones, it's like Fred goes to Barney, like, oh my God, I got fucking pterodactyls. I got fucking pterodactyls from fucking that pterodactyl. Oh my God.
Think of Barney's like, hey, Fred, let's go on Backpage and see what we can find. I think it looks on Backpage, it's just a fucking stone tablet. If it's not me, it's free.
Wilma's vibrator comes out. It's just a fucking wet beaver. It's like, it's a living.
It's a living.
Fred, tell her to...
Beats Fred,
I know water's... I know bath is not a thing, but maybe you should invent it for her. And the crowd's like... Also, what kind of diapers were they using for... was there crime in the Flintstones? What's his name? Barney stealing cereal. That was the equivalent. If that was modern day, that wouldn't be funny. That wouldn't be a commercial. That'd be an intervention.
They'd be like,
reshoot all the Flintstone cereal ads and add the intervention music. They're not funny. They're not. He's got a problem.
He's like, Barney, you have a problem. Barney. You gotta talk.
Yeah, but now's not the time, Fred. Now's not the time. We're being serious. Okay?
What am I sitting here, guys?
Fred, look at your... Barney, look at your feet. Look how rough your feet are. That's not from starting and stopping cars with it. That's from stealing windows.
No.
You have sex with dinosaurs to get cereal. And I don't understand how you get cereal.
Everybody does. Don't you guys?
Also, I'd like to point out,
we have the concept of a refrigerator, but yet there's no ice in it. It's just like a big duck's mouth. Like what?
Yeah. Niggas got a big boulder that's just they just carve a hole in it. And like, yo, this shit'll keep shit cold. Should be alright.
They got an air fryer. It's just a dinosaur like breathing heavy. Like,
these'll be ready in 3 hours, Fred. Like,
yeah. The Manimals was mad sad, yo. All the Manimals needed solo. They all said the same shit, that it's a living. Yeah. Like,
they never show any of the Black Cave people, which tells you either the Black Cave people live in a different part of town. George Jetson was, no, not George Jetson. Fred Flintstone was the original MAGA, and he didn't like the mixing of the races and shit.
Nah.
Think about that. Think about that.
Open your third eye. You know what I'm saying? The Black man wasn't even there with the Flintstones because the white man, the Caucasian man, comes from the Caucasus Mountains. He's retrograde.
You know Guess what? I'll take it even further. Advanced, when the Flintstones was happening, Black people had libraries and planetariums in Africa.
That's right, God.
They don't want you to know that. You know that's why. That's Hanna-Barbera.
That's right.
More like Hannah the Babylon thing. Okay?
Whoa.
Understand that.
Whoa.
Understand that, okay?
Think about it.
You know what I'm saying? Think about it. You're an older white guy. You're like, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to make a bunch of cartoons for kids. That's called propaganda, nigga. Okay?
Yeah.
Or you just did that out of the goodness of your heart? No.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't. You trying to get some bread and trying to indoctrinate some kids, nigga.
Exactly.
That's what you was trying to do.
Mr. People think Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, oh, he's so good and he taught you how to be a good neighbor. No.
Nah.
Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood taught you to low-key to be a sneakerhead because he came home and put on new sneakers. Unnecessary. Unnecessary.
Talk about it. He
and
changed the outfit for no reason.
Who paid for Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood? Who? The MTA? Think about it. Who else got a train in their house?
Hmm?
Who? Huh?
Okay. You know he's smoking dust and shit? Nigga had an imaginary kingdom and shit.
Ooh,
like
ooh.
He's on drugs and shit.
Think
encouraging
about it.
Hallucinogen use.
If I come to you and I'll be like, yo, bro, after this, I'm, you know, there's a train at my house. I'm going to go see the king of make-believe. You'd be like, this nigga's doing meth.
Yo,
this
yeah. You definitely smoke. Like, nah, bro. Did you just smoke DMT? What happened?
Choo-choo. I'm trying to see maybe. I'm trying to see Lady Elaine on the land. Listen, bro.
Yo, I want to see some crudely made puppets talk.
Yeah. So, like, if we were in Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood and we were in the land of make-believe, within 10 minutes, we would start a coup. We'd start a revolution.
Oh,
those
yeah.
Those puppets would try to burn down that. I'd be like, so wait, y'all live out here on the other side of the train tracks while these fat cat puppets live out here eating croutons?
They were like, look at them.
Libertad.
Look at them. Changing twice a day. While you here wearing the same outfit every day, that's made out of felt from Michaels.
Lady Elaine has to die. They're like, her tied to the train tracks and shit. They're like, yo. They're like, yo. Henrietta Pussycat. Fire the first shot so we know you with us. She's like,
yo.
I don't want to do that. I'm like,
pussy.
All right.
Literally.
All right, so y'all don't want to be free? Y'all don't want to be free?
Huh?
Y'all want to remain in the land of make-believe? Y'all don't want the land of reality? All right.
Let
me show you what happens to people who don't get down with revolution. And they just have, like, I just show, move a curtain. It's just, like, Daniel the Striped Tiger just hanging from a noose.
This nigga's like,
I'm like, get down or lay down. I'm like, at the count of, listen, at 3 a.m., we're strapping mad bombs to the front of this fucking trolley, and we're taking over Mr. Rogers' shit. Fuck that.
That's it.
This nigga got money for cardigans. This nigga got money for sensible sneakers. This nigga singing inside his house by himself. What? Nah.
What the fuck this motherfucker think he is?
Okay.
Fuck out of here.
I'm too coked up. I'm like, after that? Yo, Sherry? Yo, she out here running around with sheep? Where? Lamb chop?
Wow.
That ain't halal. That ain't allowed. Child's
play along? Will kids come to play along? Word? Play along to what? Y'all didn't say what they were playing along to. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, I'm being told that Showtime will not be green lighting our Boko Haram for kids, so.
Boko Haram for kids!
Hey, kids! What's that noise? It's like a car blows up, but it's just like the Teletubby thing, but kind of different intro.
Yay!
Like,
yay!
Wow, that's dark. That gotta get extra problematic.
That's the sun is drinking human blood. Like, hooray!
Hey.
Yay!
But in all seriousness, you know, Bodega Boys, Free Palestine, we're throwing that out there. I don't know why you people, you know what's weird about this? It's like,
I feel like, yo, fam, you know, not to cut you off, I feel like we've become the Ja Rule that Dave Chappelle spoke of back then, whenever it was like, yo, well, but what do they think about it? I'm like, fam, what do you give a shit what I think about? Like, well, why don't you do read some shit?
It's more like, if you fuck with the podcast and you just hear what we say about it, you don't need us to, like, make a post about it. Like, you already know our political leanings and stuff like that. Fam. Even though somebody was like, wasn't Jesus Yang Gang? And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Like, have you lost your mind? Anyway, I was actually Tang Gang. I love the taste of space.
Oh, oranges. So good.
Yes. So or good. Or if it's the early 2000s, I like Tang Gang, which means, you know, Ma, you don't have to shower after you go to work out, you know, if you just want to leave. Like a 9-volt battery, you know.
Damn, this should be it.
But what's funny about the Free Palestine thing is you could go, because I remember I went to a march in 2014. For Free Palestine and all that. But now people are just like, what are you doing on your Twitter? And it's wild because if you know how you feel about it, you're just like, I'm not just going to post something just to post something. Meanwhile, MC Shitty Pants posts some meme he found on the TikTokers. And all of a sudden, everyone's like, oh my God, an ally. Oh, he's better than Bella Hadid. And you're like, yo, he doesn't know what the fuck he just posted.
Fam. Like, he don't know. Remember when Dwight Howard just tweeted Free Palestine and then deleted it? Because he didn't know, like... He's like,
yeah, because everyone, because back in the day, if you tweeted shit, you had your handlers came to you and was like, take that shit down. You know, shit was different. And now, it's just like, yo, people, like, I understand people was like, what about visibility? You need to get it out there. And I'm like, fam, I'm going to make y'all really sad right now. Twitter is not that big compared to the rest of the world. We be on Twitter like, yo, this shit is pop, yo. Twitter makes the world create. Like, no.
Dog.
Twitter's not bigger than, fam, if you saw Facebook's numbers compared to Twitter,
Shoot yourself. Oh my God, you'll murder yourself.
And this is what makes Facebook scary. There's a population of Facebook that if they can't log into their original account, they just make a new one. They just say, fuck it. They start from scratch.
Yeah, who cares?
Twitter can't compete with that.
No.
People have been on Twitter with the same account for 13 years.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, your aunt Cheryl over here locked herself out, made a whole new account just to follow what's going on with the Real Housewives. She's on her 10th account this year. That's where... Listen, bro. Hello. Right.
Yo, listen. You know what it is? Motherfuckers on Facebook just being on Facebook. Motherfuckers on Twitter chasing clout.
Yeah.
Chasing clout, boy.
They do anything
for clout. Twitter got the carrot with the fucking... Twitter's a carrot on a stick, bro. Facebook is just like, yo, y'all want to talk about QAnon and shit? Yo.
But I get the difference because when you have an office job, you need something like Facebook where you log in all day and it's just the shit.
It just kill time.
Like, you can't do that. Yeah. You can't do that on Twitter because Twitter be having weird waves and shit because Twitter will love some shit in the morning. And then by noon, they'll be like, this person punched me in the pussy back in 2015. And then the other person comes out. And you're just like, holy shit. And then, like, if you haven't been on it all day, you show up. And you was like, yo, remember this tweet from 9 o'clock? Yo, I love this guy. He's hilarious. He's the future. Like, oh, you like serial rapist, Jesus? That's who you support now?
Huh?
Wow. You like Epstein? I
thought I knew you.
I'm like, I just like the tweet. It's like I did that tweet about Dr. Fauci and Rob Gronkowski, you know, Gronk. And somebody was like, oh, you fuck with Gronk now? Wow. And I was like, I hit Google so fast. I was like, what did he do? I was like, I know he's a patriot or whatever. I know they do some fucked up. I was like, is he canceled? Then I was like, am I canceled? What did I do? I just did a joke. Nah, what the fuck?
You're not. That's why I don't even aim down sights, bro. I just hit fire on Twitter all day. I don't give up.
But then, bro, I called my friend Dave Chappelle and I was like, bro, what should I do? And he was like, Jesus, fuck them. And I was like, Dave, you're right. Can I get some money? And he hung up. So
yeah. That's the twist. That's the plot twist. That's the M. Night Shyamalan for niggas like us who are almost there. You know, I had a conversation with some nigga. He's like, yo, you out here doing it. Yo, you doing it, dude. I was like, nigga, I'm not doing it. You know what's doing it? Sitting on multi-millions of liquid money. That's doing it. That's like, you're not doing it. If you're like, no. To quote Joel Santana, you thought you was doing it, but you wasn't doing it. Fuck out of here. This shit could go away in a heartbeat. Are you, man? Your motherfuckers make me sick. It's not like an old man complaining and shit, but that's what it, that's what I am. I'm 38 years old now. I'm an old man complaining. Enjoy. You know what I'm saying? Fuck out of here. Go on Twitter
well,
and get these shits off.
You have some happiness in your life because the Knicks are the fourth seed. So
that's right, baby!
You got that.
Woo! You brought me right back. Thank you for bringing me back from the edge. The Knicks are locked in fourth seed. Home court advantage. Let's fucking go. All you Knicks haters, you know, eat a dick.
I just saw an amazing play with the Nets, and it was like it used everybody, and it ended with KD jamming the ball off the backboard. But I'm going to say Randall. Julius Randall's block. Dare I say it. He did the defensive block in the fourth quarter. That was probably the biggest defensive play in the history of the NBA.
Of the modern NBA? Yeah, absolutely.
In the modern NBA. Since the dead ball era.
No disagreements. Yep.
And some people were like, Jesus, the dead ball era was baseball. I was like, it still applies. Just find out when the dead ball era started in baseball. And I'm talking about that. Stupid. Okay?
You know what I'm saying? Do the math.
Don't fact check my facts. Because fact checking my facts is disrespectful. And that fact checking my facts makes me the female in the relationship, which makes me, like, the lesser. So I'm not allowed to...
Talk to him. Talk to him, God. Talk to him.
So wait a minute. So when you fact check my facts, all of a sudden, now I got to get the top bunk? That's not how it goes, my nigga. Okay? Then you set the whole jail on fire? It's like, fuck it. If I can't get... It's like, it's not even that necessary.
No, bro. No. No. Chill. There was Trini Tyrus just chilling over there playing spades, bro. You just fucked up the whole night. By lighting the whole shit on fire.
Like, it was cool. Bro, we get Hallmark in here. Like, they're starting this summer Christmas movie.
Yo, come on. Christmas in July. It's about to be fun. It's about to be a fun summer.
Come on, bro. We're halfway to Christmas. Don't fuck it up. Come on.
Yo. My God. Yeah, I mean, listen. We're back. The world's reopening slowly. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I don't. I don't understand that. How we, the America's like, yeah, we do. Listen, shout out to the pandemic. America's doing the thing old rappers used to do where the final track was just them shouting out other rappers for 3 minutes and it was
weird.
And they'd be like, yo, shout out to Questlove. Shout out to
Rock,
Chuck,
Rock,
Rock,
oh, my nigga,
shout
Rock,
out to,
Rock,
yo,
Rock,
shout
Rock,
out to
Rock,
Snoop
Rock,
and everyone on the West Coast. Shout out to Heavy D up in Mount Vernon, Money Earning. And he was just like, I don't know any of these guys, but this is amazing. Wow.
Yo.
Wow.
Shout out to E-40 and the Bay, Romper Room Gang. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to y'all.
That's what Biden and them are doing. They was like, yo, shout out to essential workers. Y'all hold us down. Yo, shout out to everyone making the vaccine. You guys do this.
Meanwhile,
India is like, oh, hello. Like,
our shit is on fuego.
Like, shit is not good here. And we're just like, yo, that's y'all. That's y'all. Because listen, nigga, we at 80% capacity. Niggas are sitting at bars.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Baby.
And then the CDC was like, yo, fam, like, my nigga, you don't got to wear, you only got to wear a mask if you don't trust the nigga you around. And this is basically the CDC's policy for masks is the same policy for unprotected sex. Like,
yo. Like, yo, I know you. I know you're not going to do me like that.
It's like that, but then it's just like, if the other person's too quick to be like, yeah, it's all right. You'd be like, whoa.
Yo, hold on. Whoa.
No pushback?
Hey.
No, none whatsoever?
Listen. Hey.
Oh, so wait. So you're telling me I put this in the USB slot on the right side on the first try? I don't trust that. No. Get out of here with your dirty twat. I'm putting the mask on.
Taking it back to the old school, don't put me at risk. You know what I'm saying?
You got to do the old school problematic trick now and put a finger in someone's mouth and then get them to smell it. Yeah, bro.
Like, yo, I smell like this serene, B. I'm good. I told you I'm good.
I'm like, oh, you've been in the house all day? Really? Okay, because I don't smell like you've been in the house all day.
Let me see.
Like,
yo, open your mouth.
Wow.
Motherfucker.
But then... Remember back, I was going to say we're going to age up. I guess no. Back in the, I would say like the 80s and 90s, there were specific types of people called bug chasers who specifically were having unprotected sex with people because they wanted to get AIDS and they liked the risk of it. So if you out here raw dogging the air, that's not the same at all.
It's not the same at all.
I have no idea why I brought that up, but.
Yeah.
Just be careful.
I thought you were going to go the other way and go to the dude. I think it was the dude. Speaking about Mount Vernon, the dude who went around and like was HIV positive. He was just like raw dogging everybody on purpose.
Yeah.
Like, trying to give everybody else HIV. I was like, dog. Like,
and they changed the laws because of him.
Yeah. I was like, fam, what the fuck? Like, well, yeah.
Yes, what the fuck? But if we're talking hip-hop, Big L said, if I get AIDS, every cutie in the city got it, so. To be fair, he said that on a song called Devil's Son. So I don't know what you were expecting. He's not going to do.
I like how people...
He's not doing just the two of us, Will Smith style with Lucifer. Okay? It's not like
that. I'm like, yo, what do y'all think 90s rappers about? Like, yo, the niggas, they had the Grave Diggers, Children of the Corn, like Devil's Son. Songs like Devil's Son, like, fam, what do you think the content of this music is going to be? You think it's going to be fucking Sunshine and Daisies, my nigga? We skipping through a field? Like, it's opening true. A checking account? Like, no. I mean, we're talking about wild, satanic shit.
You got to wonder, because some people, you know, there's a lot of people who, they be on Twitter giving you shit about being woke, and then they got a Wu-Tang tattoo, and you're just like, so you just ignore all the rape references, huh? And they're like, I didn't even catch that.
Well.
Jesus. And now I'm not going to explain it, but if you go back, you'll get them. You'll get them.
Right. Oh, man. Oh, they're yeah. Right. They're all over the place. I love Ghostface, but Ghostface was very problematic.
To make it even worse, it's like, it's the same get around that they use on some tube sites where they be like, they add one letter to rape and it brings up different videos. And if your website is not automatically blanking that, you run a scumbag website. And that's all I'm going to say on that. That's all I'm going to say on that.
Somebody just got started sweating and going through the server. Shit.
Yeah, bro,
like, yo, you're right. Correction is a punishment, God.
There you go. So new music dropped this week. We got new J. Cole.
No features, again. Again. No features. So when it goes platinum, you know what everybody's going to say.
But at this point, is it going platinum? Does he have no features because he doesn't want any features? Or is it like, well, you just don't do the work? You just don't make phone calls. And it's just like, yo, like, maybe on the other side of the record company's like, nigga, you ain't calling none of these niggas? You ain't get no verses from none of these niggas? He's like, nah, shit. My,
bro, you didn't call any of the babies?
Nah.
Baby?
I got D-Wade and Gabrielle Union's baby, but she don't really know English like that. So her verse was unusable, bro. Like,
wow.
So like,
fam, you were supposed to fucking call. Yo, my God. Yo, this fucking guy, Jermaine, it's fucking Jermaine again, bro. Yo,
nah,
he don't fucking call anybody.
You know what?
Can you listen to me first?
Can you listen to me?
No, hold on a second.
Because I'm only going to say this once.
Go ahead, Dreamville. Tell me about your dreams. Go ahead.
I'm not going to tell you about my dreams. I'm telling you about reality. Enjoy that album. I can't be here for the marketing because I'm joined a basketball league in Africa. So I have to leave in an hour.
What?
Yeah.
You did what?
Yeah, they got the jersey made already. So I got to go. Like,
yo, you fucking... Yo, this guy's going to drive me crazy. Yo, this guy's going to drive me out of my mind. Yo, listen. No, come here. No, come down here. Get off the phone and come down here. Listen. Yo, this guy, he didn't call Cardi B. He didn't call any of the babies at all. Now this guy's got to... He's going to fucking... Uh-oh. Oh, my God. Listen, yo, you hear him? Yo. Now this motherfucker's going to Cameroon to play basketball. Mm-hmm. I can't do it. I quit. I fucking quit.
How much basketball you play? A lot.
Wow. Yeah. Why didn't you call 21 Savage? Again, huh? You on his album. Why can't he be on your album?
Because I did try to call him, but then I smoke a lot of weed, so I didn't know if I have him in that context with it would start with a 2 or actual T for 21.
Because then, like, you couldn't just scroll through. You couldn't just go in the search thing. Huh? No, couldn't do that, right? Too busy practicing the triple threat to take over Cameroon and the Cameroon basketball league.
I started
searching.
I'm searching, and I'm like 21, 21, 21. Oh shit!
Uh-huh.
We play a quick game of 21, and I got my car and I drove to the course and played 21 for like 5 hours. That's how I came up with the idea to go play basketball because I'm mad nice.
Yeah,
I'm mad nice. I don't read books, so I don't got time. Yeah. My brain is full of basketball shit. No books. All right.
Listen, you fucking jerk. I'm the one that signed you up for the celebrity basketball game. You dunked one time. Let me tell you something. Whew. Let me gather myself. You were playing against fucking Arnie Duncan, Jermaine. Okay. It's a different game. You're playing against pro basketball players now. You're going to hurt yourself. You got to come back in the studio in 3 months. We got to do another album. With features this time.
Nah, what's wrong with the album I gave you? There's more than enough on there. There's got to be like at least.
No!
There's like maybe six really hot tracks.
Listen, I'm not gonna insult your art.
Okay? At Fresh Direct.
I'm not gonna insult your art. Mm-hmm. All I'm gonna say is,
it might have been a little bit of an oversight, okay, to release a fucking album in 2021 with no fucking features. Who do you think you are? Who do you think you fucking are? Are you Drake? Let me ask you a question, Jermaine.
I'm J. Cole, professional basketball player, nigga.
Wow.
Matter of fact,
wow.
You harshing to my high. Wow.
Wow. Okay.
You know what? You hear that? I gotta go.
Here. You know what? Here's a fuck. What is this? Is this a 5-gallon drum of beeswax? What is this? Oh my
Yo,
god.
Yo, peace, my nigga. Yo.
Yo, I'm on fucking the court. Guy.
I'm doing dunks. I don't care about what you dunk, yo.
Yo, he's rapping.
Jermaine
about
D is cold, I'll be rapping. Yo, if I don't hit shots, I'll be capping, yo. I'll be mad lyrical and spiritual. Yo, I don't read books because the they're mad. You know what?
Right. Cut the fucking beat off. Cut the fucking beat off! God
this.
Damn it! Jesus
this.
Christ. Ooh. Yo, my nigga, yo, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm 20
years old.
I'm
not even, I don't even need this. I gotta go see, I'm going on the Joe Button podcast. I'm out, bye.
Relax.
Yo, man, yo, J. Cole's management team got me mad as fuck. Like, yo, dog.
Yo, you know no podcast.
And you go to Cameroon? Like, what? Oh, I don't know why I said Cameroon. This shit just sounds fire.
It works. Also, shout out to the Joe Button podcast, which, like, now niggas was like, first of all, people was like, you got to be happy about that. Like, why? What the fuck? Why would I be happy after the Joe Button podcast ended? The shit was, like, people enjoyed it.
That's like being on the Knicks and being like, yeah, the Devil Rays lost. Like, or the Rays lost. Like, man, we're not even.
It would be different. It's not even about. No, it would be like being on the Knicks and then they. All right. They're like, hey, terrible news. The Atlanta Hawks plane just went down. Everyone died. And you're like, hooray. We don't have to face them in the, like, first round. Like, no, nigga, that's not how it works. Like, no. Like, anytime you got, like, a podcast that provides people, like, people enjoying is getting people through shit and shit, it just ends. Shit is very dramatic. And it's just like.
And the wild thing is that, like, yo, I know this for a fact because I had a roommate. Joe Budden's fan base is very dedicated to Joe Budden. You know what I'm saying?
I had a very long argument. I was on Joe Budden's website when he was a mouse. Remember that? Way back in the day. Back before there was Twitter.
When he had beef with Ransom.
Okay. Take it back. Back when he was rapping about halfway houses. You know the vibes.
Yeah. Hey, do any of y'all remember New Jersey Devil? The DJ?
Woo! That all time music.
He's like, I'm an A&R somewhere right now. So, ha-ha. He's like, produced Doja Cat's last album.
Shout out to Doja Cat. She always be popping, locking over fucking disco beats and shit. Kids on TikTok, they're like, all these songs are so great. I was like, this is disco, y'all. They're like, well, how would you know? They was like, yeah, you know it because you've been around forever. I've only been on Earth 18 years. I'm like, point.
True.
Point.
Yo.
Yeah.
Yo,
yeah.
Not right. Yo. Right. To quote Nas, no idea is original. You know what I'm saying?
Ego.
There's nothing new under the sun.
He stole that from Ellen DeGeneres. So,
you know. Wow. See? Double entendre.
Shout to Ellen. She's ending her show because she said it's not a challenge anymore, which is just like.
What? Isn't that what you work towards for your job to not be a challenge anymore? You don't want to wake up every day like, oh, I got to challenge myself to talk to this guy with that fedora and. Like, ask Bill Gates how much Rezzaroni costs.
I got deep questions for this guy from this viral video. It's like, no. So
no, what are you talking about? Like, you kidding me?
So we're here to announce that we will be talking Ellen Spot. Our show will now be coming on Mondays and Thursdays at 9 a.m.
CBS, y'all.
It's going to be live. So enjoy
No cursing, no delays. You know what I'm saying?
No cursing, everything. We're not changing shit at all.
No 5-second delay.
It's gonna be like Price is Right, and people are gonna not Price is Right. What's the one where Deal or No Deal or whatever, and where people are dressed up in costumes, but everyone's dressed up in like sex costumes. So it's just like get up for the sexy waiter,
got his cock hanging out. Listen, man. I hope that you guys are being responsible out here. We touched on it and the world opening back up, et cetera, and like Joe Biden just giving shout outs at the end of his posse cut. Be careful, guys, because we love you. I'm lying. I don't love anybody. I'm a nihilist. But enjoy and be safe, because that's what really matters.
In these is this related times. To your birthday? This
No, I'm just doing it like a random PSA. Just a random PSA. You know what I'm saying? Because I like COVID is not good. It's bad. You know what I'm saying? That's as simple as I'll keep it. Because I don't like to dig too deep into shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right. <That's... laughs> Yo.
Keep your fucking mask on.
Yes. Who's taking their mask off anyway? Oh, you probably own too many masks to take them off now. So, makes no sense. Also, wearing a mask is cool, especially if you're a person of color. Because now you can sneak around like a ninja. And you can give cops dirty looks and they don't know who you are. So that's always good.
Also,
and then also, when you wear a mask, people can't tell if you're about to rock their shit. Because all they can see is your eyes. So they can't see your face. So
if you wear shades and a mask, woo, you go Rockavelli. Also, like, if your favorite brands are now making masks. You want to swoosh on your grill? You know what I'm saying? Go cop. You know what I'm saying? A little athleticism shit. You know what I'm saying? You could match a mask to your outfit and shit. There's a lot of options out there. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to my homegirl who she said that because she wears the mask and sunglasses, no one can tell she's Asian and she doesn't have to worry about like people attacking her because she's kind of small. So, shout out to that. I mean,
That's true.
New York is wild. You know, you gotta move. Like, you know what I'm saying? You gotta move incognito, low key.
Also, yeah. And if you have a beard, get a mask that covers your beard. You know what I'm saying? They make them. You know what I'm saying? Neck gaiters, all that shit. You know what I'm saying? Just rock something. Do something, you know what I'm saying? Make it look like you give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? At least. Please.
Shout out to SNL. I went last week, saw Elon Musk there. I have no idea why you people worship.
Whose idea was that?
Enjoy him. What?
Why would like I'm following along with you. Yeah. Like why do why is
Lorne Michaels, you know how he does. Like he was like, could I have the Desus and Mero on or should I have Elon Musk on? And probably better to have Elon Musk on because we're going to curse and probably be like, this shit is whack or change some shit. Or be halfway through a sketch and just turn the camera and be like, I'm sorry. Like, this is really bad. Like, we knew.
Our fault. Yo, they just told us to go. And
yeah. We'd be like, yo, we knew since Monday the sketch was really bad, but we were like, yo, we're going to get on air and flame them live on air because this shouldn't even have made it to Tuesday, like, honestly.
You know? This is really but, bad. You know, but really it did, bad. So we're going to cook it.
Matter of fact, we're going to finish doing the sketch, and every time something's problematic, we're going to look directly at the camera. So they'll be like, yo. They'll be like, yo, my baby's on fleek. And we'll be like,
oh, wow.
Oh, your baby's on fleek, huh? Your baby's on fleek.
Ooh. Wow. Yikes. Wow. Okay.
Wow. I'm the grandma, period. And you're like, ew. Like, no, it's not.
No, it's not. That is not it at all. Yo, also, Elon Musk, I feel like he's like the way he talks and shit. Like, something's going on. Something's going on there. I feel like him getting a hairline gave him way too much confidence. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I'm saying? And like now he's just out here wilding, just saying whatever. Like, yo, Doge to the moon, all this wild stuff. They had the Cybertruck like demo during SNL. Which is like, I was like, all right, that's cool and everything, but like, fam, you're mad weird. Like, it's such a weird ass pick, like, for SNL. Like, don't they usually go with, like, people who can, like, act or have done some type of entertainment?
Like, well, I mean, he does have fans because there were a lot of people in the crowds that were really big Elon Musk fans. And then he was just like, oh, I have Aspinger's, that's why I talk like that. It's like, no, that's not really why. You talk like that because you're a rich dickhead. Like, it's clear. And then Grimes was there. She was in one sketch. She had a panic attack and had to go to the hospital afterwards, which is just that, like, if your name is Grimes and you're, like, married to Elon Musk with a baby or you guys have a baby together and your baby's name is, like, an irrational number, like, you're doing a lot. I don't know how much sympathy I got for y'all, but shout out to them. And shout out to Elon Musk trying to destroy Bitcoin by saying Tila, excuse me. Tila, one of the greatest rappers in Suave House,
Yo. Tesla,
they said that they're no longer going to take Bitcoin as payment for Teslas, but Desus, the Bitcoin Baron, says you should be holding on to it. You shouldn't be spending your Bitcoin. Hold on to it, bro. Just hold on to it. Take the Bitcoin, squeeze it in your hand. Think about it like a fucking clam. A clam gets a piece of sand in its mouth. What does it do? Does it open it up and spit it out? No.
No.
It holds on to it.
A pearl.
It holds on to it and it keeps spitting on it like, open your mouth. Open your mouth, you fucking whore. Yeah, it keeps doing that until a precious pearl is made. And that's what happens. That's why you got to hold on to your Bitcoin. You want to be out here playing with these fucking other cryptocurrencies with a fucking cute dog on it? Huh?
Huh?
A cute dog on currency? Currency should be ugly. It should have oppressors on it. And it should be cold and heartless. And that's what Bitcoin is. Okay? All Bitcoin is missing is the picture of a dead president that used to own slaves. And it would be 100% legal tender. And we're going to get there soon. And you're
Bitcoin
like,
about to have Jeffrey Epstein on it.
You're like, Desus, you're very, very passionate about Bitcoin. You must own a lot. And it's like, no, I don't. I don't. I'll just be bored at night. I'll just be bored. I don't know. Yeah. And also, there's one particular person I don't like on Twitter, and they're very happy about the Dogecoin they bought, and they're my nemesis. And I keep checking their Twitter page, and I want to see Dogecoin fail because I don't want them to be successful. And yes, this person is Elon Musk. So, yes, that's true.
Yeah, I mean, like, listen, I know, like, this is like the inverse of us when we're talking about like gambling, because I'm like lost in the sauce, and it just seems very Ponzi, very shaky, very like, yo, get it. If you're the first 10 motherfuckers in the door, you're G-ing off. Everybody else after you is taking an L.
Well, no, if you play it, you got to put in work to it. There's lots of ways to play it. You can hold it. You just like be like me, just buy it and hold it. You can be one of the people that you get like four screens going and you look for like when it dips and you sell it before it dips and then you rebuy on the dip so you have more than you had before because now you have more money than you did before you sold it. You got that. Then you can take it and cash it into other things. And then if you live in New York State, you can't really buy other cryptocurrencies because we have some sort of weird law, but you can like, you know, you could do funny things with your Bitcoin and buy cryptocurrencies that you wouldn't buy in New York State because technically there's no record of it until you finish the transaction. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge, if you know what I'm saying. Not saying you should break the law. All I'm saying is...
Breaking the law.
You know what I'm saying? I lied to the judge, Your Honor, for a boat full of marijuana.
Yeah, like, coke and marijuana. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Standing in front of the judge about the lie, plus I'm high, too.
Also, this
is a
hot take.
You go to court high, respect.
This is a hot take, and I've seen some people saying Desus is wrong about Jay-Z and Nas have never done a good song together. Let me clarify you. Desus is never wrong. It is your shitty hip hop ears. You are taking lyrical sabaros, and you're thinking it's good. You're like, oh, I love success. You had Jay-Z talking about an apartment he has never used in Trump Tower. What the fuck is good about that? Their verses, they literally are just listing off things they purchased. There's nothing lyrical about it. There's nothing.
Google Earth,
Nas got flats in other continents.
Continents? You know who's bobbing their head mad hard to that? Fucking Jerry Seinfeld, nigga. And like Jay Leno. Them nigga, they bobbing their head mad hard like, ooh, yeah. I got 38 Porsches in my garage. I got 16 flats in London. I'm like, yeah, dog, nobody else has that. Stop. Like,
so yeah, listen, they got the mid. They're bringing the mid. And then, nobody wants to hit the mid. This is my hot take. If you mention any cryptocurrency of any form, any amount, and any reference at any point of any hip-hop song, that hip-hop song is now garbage from the rip. It could be the greatest hip-hop song ever. You can make a hip-hop song about your brand new baby, about your grandma that died, about supporting Palestine, about ending slavery. If you mention Ethereum, Dogecoin, Bitcoin, any of that, garbage. I'm the meme of the guy ripping off his headphones. Nobody wants to hear that. Bitcoin and cryptocurrency are not a pillar of hip-hop. Stop it. Stop it. Okay?
Yo, listen. I'm going to tell you right now. I'm sorry to tell you, but Fabulous is hard at work in the lab trying to make a Bitcoin, like double entendre work right now as we speak. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
You know me. I had to test the quarter with my...
Coin.
Had to quest. had to test the quarter with my teeth, you know, a Bitcoin. You're like, get the
guy. Wow.
Nah. Like,
oh, brother.
Oh, brother. This guy stinks.
It's not necessary. It's not necessary. Listen,
not
we,
at all. We don't need
like,
to do that.
No need to talk about specific currency. You never heard a verse and someone was like, yo, let me get a case quarter. And some of you all are like, Jesus, what is a case quarter? And you know what? I'm like, go ask your father.
Go ask your dad.
Because he's clearly my age. He's clearly my age, okay? Dummy. I'm not explaining this shit to you. You think
fucking
it's cute
bozo.
Where you're like, oh my God, I like your old references. You know what? I just went on your page and I saw on your IG 4 weeks ago, you were holding two balloons. One said two, the other said zero. They were gold. Those are birthday balloons. Get your young ass out of here.
Get out of here.
Get out of here. You don't even know what LaFleur, a Scotia means. Get out of here.
Yo, come on, son. You wasn't there.
Get out of here.
All the motherfuckers in football jerseys? No.
Okay.
You never ran from a shooting in front of Speed?
I know that feeling when I drop a hip-hop actual factual on you and you just giggle because you don't know what the fuck I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Huh?
God okay. Damn.
When I talk about, I'm like, hey, remember? Shaheem got his face slashed in a nightclub, but he kept rapping afterwards. You're like, no, that little chuckle, no. I don't like that. That means you're thinking about what these young kids think about. You're thinking about hot chip, being bisexual, lying, and doing BuzzFeed quizzes. And I don't like it. I don't like it.
Not at all. You know what I'm saying? You over here practicing dances, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. TikTok and shit, trying to get on Fortnite. It's not going to happen.
They're not moving their legs. They're just moving their arms? No.
Yeah.
No. Okay?
Nah.
Whoa, what is this? You're abroad and you're nice in war zone? Get out of here.
Nah. Beat it. Man, I like my male toxicity here, all right?
Whoa. So the WNBA's been around for 25 years, and they're actually playing well when they got some superstars. Now you want to show them some respect? Get out of here.
Get out of here. Take a fucking hike. Well, you wasn't there in 96.
Okay.
Huh? I had a Teresa Witherspoon throwback jersey from the New York Liberty inaugural.
You tell them, Paul.
All right?
I lost a G on a free throw from Dawn Staley. All
right? That's right.
You know that song, oh my God.
Yeah.
I was there when Cheryl Swoops did the first female dunk. And yes, we call it a female dunk because that's different than a male dunk.
Yeah.
As opposed to an SB dunk. I don't want to get into that, but you guys get what I'm talking about.
It's a little, so you guys over there in that downtown area talk about that type of stuff. We don't talk about that over here.
You know, you guys over there on Avenue A.
Yeah.
If that's what it even stands for.
Yeah, yeah. Hey. Yeah, more like Avenue A-N-A-L.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Yeah.
Bro, so he lives in Soho, and I was like, so? Yeah, ho. Yeah, I told him, bro. Yeah.
Got him.
Stay off the 4 train. Next stop, Parkchester. Yeah.
Yeah. Keep that one in your back pocket. That's a good one.
Exactly. We're the guys on the train that at first are lovable, but then they make you depressed because you're like, damn, you remind me of my uncle if he stopped using drugs. You're like, yeah, I knew him, bro.
Yo,
oh my God.
Yo, we was in daytime together. I got clean.
Oh my God, Mero.
He died.
Guess who our uncle was? Dirty Needle Doug. Oh my God. Oh my God. Remember? His shit was always caked up on the end. He never cleared the blood out of it.
Wow. Damn, Jesus. Doug. You cool with Doug?
Remember we called his needle? We called his needle breakfast cereal because every time you pressed on it, you heard snap, crackle, pop when it was going into your veins, bro.
Damn.
Oh my God. Listen.
Yo, his arm looked like the subway map. That shit was crazy.
Bro, remember what he'd always say before he, like, leaned out? When he was in front of IHOP, remember? And right before, like, he hit his head on the mailbox, he did the hit. He was like, haha, look, part of a balanced breakfast. And it was funny because he wasn't balanced in his head.
He was balancing.
Wow.
That motherfucker.
Oh, I miss him, bro. I miss him.
Oh, man. We used to call him Rudy Tooty, Fresh and Fruity.
Yeah, bro. And he didn't really care about, like, gender or whatever. Like, he'd, like, suck you off in the morning regardless because he had no teeth. And you'd just be like.
They used to call him Dyson.
Yeah.
Mike Dyson.
Yeah, we didn't really get the vacuum reference. He's just, like, a speech impediment. That's why he was so good with the mouth. I mean, if you get it, you know. I hope you guys enjoy this podcast because instead of, you know, like after seeing what happened with Joe Budden and them, I'm like, the future of this podcast is important. We got to make sure it's just like solid and it doesn't end. But then a little devil showed up on my shoulder, which looked like Vince Staples, by the way. I don't know what that's about. And he was like, listen, cuz. He was like, you got to milk these niggas dry. And I was like, what? He was like, every time you and Mero use the problematic light, you should have a voice come on before and be like, you have to unlock this part. You have to pay extra to hear the Sucio.
Ooh.
Are we... So we are here to announce
podcasts that due to Cash App,
we is not even, no, no, because that sounds bad. You hear in-app purchases, you're like, ooh, I don't want to do that.
Oh, no, ooh.
Oh, why? That no. sounds disgusting. No, no.
Bonus
what
content.
What we are doing is called Audio Only Fans.
Ooh.
So please join.
AOL.
Support. Support. We're sex workers. Do we do sex work? No. We're sexy when we work.
You know what I'm saying? How about that? We're Sucio boys. That? You know what I'm saying? It's... Yo! Listen, when you don't know the answer to something, you ask a question. Mm-hmm. Are the people involved... So, like, if you're a... Let's say you're a grip on a Pino set. Are you a sex worker? Or are you just a film producer?
Oh, see, even that depends. Are you union? Because you can't really be union. You know what I'm saying? First of all, if you say you're union on the set of like a sex
team, a Pino, like, they're like, here. Nah.
But no, you're not a sex worker. You're sex worker adjacent. Because I think if you're just walking around with like black jeans, kind of showing the crack of your butt with three rolls of duct tape on your belt. You know what I'm saying? Putting down grips that stupid ass people like me and Mero completely ignore. And they're like, yeah, reset. And I'm like, where? They're like, I don't know. The bright neon tape I just put down in front of you dick. But they can't say that. That takes some leverage away from the person getting reamed in and out in two holes on the bed. So, you know what I'm saying? There's a pecking order there. But, yeah. Respect you. Shout out to those people who are professional enough to be on the set on a porno site. Because you got people who giggle too much. There's people who don't respect when the performer's like, yo, I'm putting on a robe. You got people trying to take, like, photos. You know?
Oh, yeah, like that. To put out on their own. Yeah, it's scummy.
Then you got, like, scummy guys who are just like, whoa, like, you know, now she didn't catch all of that. Some of it's on the carpet. You know, you mind if I take that home? And it's just like, whoa. Like,
whoa!
Listen. Certain people got different definitions for the term crafty. Okay?
Yeah, listen.
And that's all I'm saying.
Shaming, dog.
That's all I'm saying.
It's different types of cheese, okay? That's all I'm going to say. There's a lot of different types.
Some of y'all are like, oh, that's disgusting. You guys just make a joke about someone on set eating ejaculate. And I was like, we once eat quinoa, so.
Okay.
All right.
There you go. Like,
you know what I'm saying? Don't judge us.
Very, excuse me.
Okay.
We've eaten in LA before, okay? We had to one time go into Erewhon and just make a whole meal from Erewhon products. You know how hard that is? When everything is ling,
I don't want to make things spicy,
root.
But if you look, that's why that show we had on a certain network ended, because that one meal at Erewhon, that meal cost...
Might as well been Enron.
$200,000 for one piece of ham on like a brioche bun. It makes no sense.
At all. I don't understand it.
And I remember we went and we paid for it, and they were like, what are you doing? And we were like, no, we want to eat it. And they was like, no, all the food you make here are NFTs. And I was like, what? So how do we eat? And then they called us non-fungible.
Yeah, I still don't know what the fuck that means. Like,
That's a slur.
Yeah, because my iPhone won't tell me. Like, I hit look up, and it's just like, yo, you don't want to know. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so here's how you check. Like, get into an argument with someone of a different race and be like, you know what? That's why all of y'all are non-fungible. So you gotta say. See how they react to that.
That shit will get you punched in the face on Southern Boulevard in under five seconds.
What? Why you gotta bring race into this, bro? Huh? Listen, I know it's a pandemic. Me and your father, we're both vaxxed up. And we missed last year and the kids and everything, but... I've seen your videos on OnlyFans and such, and I mean, I just don't feel comfortable with you bringing your non-fungible kids to the table.
Yeah.
I understand you're in the top 1% of creators. Me and your father were very proud of it, but listen, I saw your baby. It's basically an animated GIF, and I don't feel comfortable with that underneath my house.
Don't really like it. Don't feel good about it.
So wait, you paid for it with Ethereum? Disgusting.
Oh, no. Ooh. We don't do that. That's too crypto. Wow. Yo, also, there's so many people in the top 1% of creators. How many are creators are there? Because, yeah. Or y'all just capping, like, deleted at 500,000 followers. Like,
put it this way. Usually,
how do we quantify that?
Usually, when you see in the top 1% of OnlyFans, you usually got the wild, chubby penis in your fist. So you're not really fact-checking. You know what I'm saying? That's not what you're there for. All right? You're not fact-checking. You're not there like, hey, can I get some pickups? Like, no. You're just like, all right. And you don't know, because it's usually like top 1% dot, dot, dot. Well, this is like top 1% of light-skinned girls with thick thighs who post between 3 and 6 on Tuesdays in Paramus. Can't beat that. She is the 1% of that. Okay?
Fam. Yo. You know what was super extra, like, scumbag? The motherfuckers that ripped the OnlyFans shit and throw it on the tube site. And the double down scumbags that are like, yo, this shit is whack. They don't even use a tripod. Like, nigga, you stole this shit.
Shout out to the homie Janice Griffith and Demi Sutra. I've seen and reported some of y'all sites on tube sites. Not because I'm a hater, because I know y'all. I'm like, fuck that. Like,
get your money.
Exactly. I've been seeing them on Twitter, like, complain. I'm like, nah, I'm going to report this shit. And that shows growth. Because would I have reported it before I knew them? No. I would have downloaded it to my 400 terabyte illegal hard drive that I keep, just like the guy who beats his meat when the volcano is coming. They're like, yo, get everything you need out your house. I don't even grab my pets. I just grab my hard drive. Like, bro, hold on, bro. I got to get the adapter. Bro, I used a FireWire. They didn't even make that anymore. I got to go back.
Yo, shout to Juki. The first time I ever heard the phrase terabyte was in relation to this man's Pino drive. He's like, yeah, I got like 4 terabytes, bro. He's like, exactly. It's all alphabetized. He's like, this tube size shit is going to go down eventually. It's not going to last. I was like, so you have 4 terabytes of Pino? Do you even know what you have? Like,
how much Pino is that? Like that, they really get down and dirty with like the folders and all that stuff, or they build web interfaces because the idea of like, it's not 92, my nigga. You're not gonna open Finder and scroll through and find your file.
You gotta switch like the icon now, display to like thumbnail so you can be like,
yeah, like now, like now, okay, you can remotely log into your Wi-Fi enabled like your box, and then it's just like being on another website, which, again, I brought this up so you guys know I'm not lying, because as someone pointed out, there was like, it feels like you lie, but your lies are always the same lies over and over again. And I'm like, that's not lying. That means something really happened. It was like when we were trying to, I'm not going to name the hotel because we almost got sued for this last time I did this, but we were trying to sell them basically a terabyte box of just like every type of porn, you name it. Just this is before the internet and shit. This was just like every type of weird porn. And so you'd be able to order it from the privacy of your room, no matter how no child porn or anything like that. But like,
right.
If you want like niggas stomping, if you want like a woman and
kicking a nigga in the asshole,
stomping on earthworms and shit, it was on there. And that's where I found. And then like the hotels was like, yo, this is a money maker. We're going to make money hand over fist and all this shit. And it just got deaded at the end. And I was like, what the fuck? That's weird. And it's kind of the same thing now, because who was it? Just eBay or Etsy just were like, yo, you can't sell pornographic shit anymore. You can't sell pornographic DVDs. You can't sell like sex. Like, they just changed all their rules. And everyone's like, I'm like, first of all, if you buying a porn DVD on eBay, you going through something, my nigga. Let that nigga get his DVD. Fam.
Yo,
let him get
real.
That DVD.
Yo, for
okay?
real. He needs that shit more than you need to change your fucking TOS.
Okay, there's two things that went on. This was either the DVD before he went to jail back when he was getting money, or his wife is in that DVD. There's no other betweens. That's it.
Or Shorty perished.
Exactly. I used to beat my meat. This got me through when I was in Elmira. Like, maybe.
Facts.
I don't know.
Facts.
I don't know.
She ain't around no more. You know what I'm saying? Okay. It makes me sad. But, you know, yeah, but we connect. We connect on that level.
But they're saying that it's because of, like, Christian-based finance groups or something like that are putting pressure on these companies.
Oh,
and in order for them to sell, you can't fuck. Because think about it. Like, Christians still run America. And not the cool Christians. Like, hey, I'm Justin Bieber. But, like, the real, hey, you're going, you know, where you're going to hell. You're going to hell for being black. I'm like,
What? When did you change the rules? I thought it was gay.
You're like,
I thought
it was gay. How's your father? Cain. You're like, what? Using the old Bible. They're like, no, excuse me. You're one of what they call those cuss people. And you're like, okay, the original slur. All right, okay.
Sir,
all right,
what? Cool.
But, yeah, that's who deaded the project way back in the day. And then it's funny because they didn't want porn at this particular hotel, but this particular hotel makes mad money year after year off of two particular porns available at every location. Do you want to know what these two corny porns are?
Oh, God.
The two wackest porns ever in the history of porn, Kim K's porn tape and Paris Hilton's porn tape.
Ew.
Imagine ordering that in 2021, my nigga.
Yo, dog, you know what I did the other day? I played Modern Warfare 3, and I forgot how to play the game completely, and I threw on my night vision goggles by accident. That's exactly what the Paris Hilton Pinot looks like. It is like just straight night vision goggles. Like, that shit is not, it's not a fun watch. Like,
and then also, that's how different society was back then. Because like, now it's just like, yo, someone's sex tape leaks. You got to like search for the shit on Twitter. They was like, yo, you want to see Paris Hilton's sex tape?
Yo, it's on TV. Am I bugging or did they have commercials on TV for that?
Yeah, commercials for it. And they were. You never heard any words about consent? Did she agree to
something?
No.
Like,
no.
Revenge porn laws? None of that. Fuck that.
It was the same as the archaeologists in Africa at the beginning of the podcast. They were like, oh, you found this.
Oh, yo, we found some Pinot. It's ours now.
They're like, Paris Hilton, can you prove this is you in it? And she's like, nigga,
It's me. I said it. Like I said, I'm Paris Hilton. Like I didn't do like the Pinot shit where I hold my like my student ID up and shit, but it's me. Like there's only one me.
I mean, you like, you don't have to hold up your student ID, but I mean, how else are you gonna get 20% off at Pro Paint? I mean, come on, bro. Like, get your shit together. Come on, you filthy bitch. You gonna pay full price for watercolors? That was from me and Miro's movie Kids 2 that we not made. They said. I remember they read the script and it was like, holy shit, how did you outdo the original? And I was like, it's easy, bro.
Yeah.
It's easy.
Duh. Like, yo, y'all should have had drones when we was running around.
They were like, so Rosario Dawson does what with the clam strips from White Castle? And I was like, bro, you want to ruin the hottest scene in the movie? Like,
come on, dog. Don't give it away.
Bro. Come on, like, bro. It's after basketball practice. They're at Gaucho's. Come on. It's New York landmarks.
Tartar sauce everywhere, bro.
They're like, explain the finger popping scene at the Astor Cube. I was like, what's to explain, bro? They just came from a performance of Blue Man Group. They're all horned up. Like, that's New York.
Regular shit, bro. They tried to get in their Joes. They got turned away because they had hats on.
Come on. You didn't grow up in New York? That's what we used to do. We used to cut school and go to matinees, like, all the time. I remember that. Like, I remember back in the day, me and Kid Mero, like, we met up at Winter Garden Theaters after, like, the Cats, you know, to throw up some graffiti. Like, shit was wild. Yeah. We bombed on a circus on a chorus line. Like, fuck that. How dare they? Like,
how? What? Motherfuckers, you wish you could.
We got to make the wild CBS sitcom where instead of, at the last minute, we get swapped at birth. Instead of growing up in the Bronx, we grow up as art kids. Like, just me and you on the train with mad scarves and shit. Like, yo.
Hey. The scarf size of a fucking duvet. Yo, our parents are fucking Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie. Like,
You hear someone, they're playing rap, it's like, five. They're playing like, I got five on it. I was like, Mero, I like that song. Wait, let's do it ourselves. Like, 540 minutes, 600 minutes. Oh, shit, Mero, listen, it's our homeboy, Lin-Manuel. Yo, Lin, what's poppin', five?
Hey. He's like, what's happening, my guys? Like,
What's happening?
Like, oh god.
We try to make a movie called In the Bronx. We go to the Bronx and we get robbed at 149th and 3rd Avenue. The train does not even make it above ground. We get robbed while the train is still underground.
No.
Give me my scarf. My mother made that for me.
I haven't been on the train in a minute. I want to be on the train. Just to see, because, like, yo, Six Line was my line. I want to see what, like, because I know when I was taking a train at 125th, every single white person that did not live in the Bronx got off the train at 125th. Every single one. It was like a mass exodus. Now you got your chair, your seats, you can stretch your legs out. I want to see how much further it's gone into, you know what I'm saying, into the Bronx. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, yo, if I you know, old viral video, the kid jumping on the train, kicking in the door on Cypress and shit. So you are, you know what I'm saying, familiar with the area. That's not, like, you know, Candyland out there. You know what I'm saying?
Now they're up there,
though. Sweet out there.
They're up here. Everyone, because of COVID, everyone, listen, the Bronx is getting gentrified. They're about to take up mad dirt and put it over by Bronx Terminal Market to make a marshland to protect some sort of luxury buildings they're putting up there. So BX, it's the only place, you know, that's still real other than Bushwick. But Bushwick makes no sense because Bushwick is just far away from nothing for no reason. And there's no trains. And you got to ride the bike. And there's a lot of alt-right people there. And when you ask people from Bushwick, they're like, I don't know any alt-right people. And you're like, your roommate. And I'm like, what? Yeah, and I'm like, your roommate. He's clearly a Proud Boy. And they're like, no, he's not. I'm like, no, like, the shirt.
He's wearing the suspenders and the shirt and shit.
Yeah. I'm like, have you ever seen him hang out with, like, another non-corny black person? And they're like, no. And they're like, how could he be, like, a racist? Like, he, you know, like, he really enjoys your podcast. And I'm like, oh.
Ooh. All right. Maybe all right, we pivot to, like, we'll just start talking about, like, finance or some shit.
That's what we're gonna start talking about pandas on this.
Yeah,
you know, just
every species of panda.
Welcome to the Panda Boys. Today we're just talking about pandas, and I mean to really just we got an expert here on pandas. You might know him from the Bronx Zoo.
Yeah,
you might know him from he's been around. He knows a lot about pandas. Give it up for
very famous individual.
Very famous individual. He's the doctor that invented pandas. His name is Designer.
Like, hey! You know. A lot of people don't know that. Talk about it. Yeah, yeah. He's feeling himself. Panda. I'd be too if I invented pandas.
Panda. I got broads in Atlanta.
Yeah. Wow, that was 2016. That feels like 10 years ago, bro.
Fam.
Wow.
Wow, that was only... Wow. 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 Really?
That was a minute.
That literally feels like it was 10 years ago. I was like, yo, that came out right after Mims, This Is Why I'm Hot. Like, that's how long ago I thought this shit came out. Yo, this... Oh, my God. Oh, boy. I have no concept of time at all.
Well,
yikes.
You know the fucking vibes. Well, it's time for some action. Well, it's also time to, you know what I'm saying, do the drop, episode 242 of the World Birthday Blessed Podcast. Happy birthday,
yes,
girl.
Yes, baby. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, my brother. Taurus gang in the building, you know what I'm saying,
you
if you're into that type of shit.
You know the fucking vibes. Fuck with the Taurus. Right. Get the horns. As always, it's been your boy, Jesus Nice, a.k.a. Young Chipotle, a.k.a. Pockets, Stay Fat Like Cheerio, a.k.a. Pockets. They stay fat like, here we go. And I think it was like some sort of award show tonight. So, I don't know. Pretend the kids were there. Because we wasn't there. But you get that vibe.
Yeah, hooray. Yeah, hooray. Shout out to y'all.
Somebody I might know you, bitch. Young Day Party. Young Hot Take. DJ Fuego. Mr. Nando's with a Rando. Mil Nervous at the Navette Cuatro. Mikhail going off. The Juve Boss. MC Luka Gunga P. Pulling up for 40 with Shorty. Hey, can you talk to me in the Uber because there's no more Uber pool.
Ooh.
And also, I don't know you. The original one plus one got a plus one, so don't make a fuss, son. These are Rossi and the Jamaican Jew. Jermaine Avocado Toast, Young Pop, the Ghost of Mufasa, Young Chacoonery without the Coonery. A.K.A. Chili Limon, left-handed reliever for the Yankees, Kale O.K. Two Phone Papi. Jones, Dizek Machina, Jake Chuckle, Stanley Cups, you remember Dr. Bonner's label, Dilute. Deonardo Trapio, Mr. 240 P, because I can get my Pinot Blurry.
Yeah.
A.K.A. DJ Woolite. Hey, listening to a little thing called Washed FM.
Oh, boy, what's DJ Woola got for us today, ladies and gentlemen?
You know the fucking vibes. I'm trying to find something that would really, you know, shake the room and make you feel what's going on.
Ooh.
Mero mentioned him earlier. Just a classic hip-hop song. Some of y'all are not from West 164th and Broadway, so you do not get the reference from the lyrical god that we're about to show. He's one of the hottest rappers. He ran hip-hop from, I want to say, February 1st to February 27th
yeah.
in 2009.
Yep.
You know who you were when you heard the...
The God.
Black album.
This is why I'm hot.
What?
This is why I'm hot. This is why. This is why. This is why I'm hot. This is why I'm hot. This is why I'm hot. This is why. This is why. This is why I'm hot.
Rest in peace, Mims. He died from too much heat. He was too hot.
Yo, he was too hot.
People realize that "This is why I'm hot" was basically an audio resume. That's what he was.
Yes. Yeah.
You had never heard of him. And he was like, here, let me break down to you the reasons why I'm hot. At the end of it, you had to make the choice. Were you going to hire Mims for this junior executive position or not? That simple. Mm. Or perhaps you were like me and you're like, you know what? I want references. I need some references. We're going to make some phone calls. Check out your background here, Mims. I like what I see. And we're going to call you back for the second interview. So
who else could correlate that you are, in fact, hot?
So listen, all you rappers out there, the first rapper to do an album or a set of songs where it's as if you're doing the employment process, like finding the initial ad on Indeed.com, sending the ad, but being so frustrated you sent the resume so many times, this time you're like, fuck it, I'm not sending the cover letter. So you send it without the cover letter. You get the phone call or the email back, and you're like, holy shit, they picked me without the cover letter. Now you're freaking out because you didn't send the cover letter. Now you're nervous on the interview. So now you smoke weed before the interview, but now you're just like, oh shit, I should spray with mad cologne so they don't know I smell. Oh, now you smell like too much cologne. Now you're mad worrisome inside the interview. But then at the interview, you see that the person interviewing you has a tuna fish sandwich for lunch and they haven't refrigerated it. And you're like, oh, they a nasty nigga. I got this.
Oh, they super nasty.
So do that, you know, Mims, and we'd be watching that. So listen, it's the Curry Goat. Jesus Spicer, Jamal Haspin, the Bronx, Celine Dion, Ray, Nephews, Nephew, the Moreno, you cannot contain, the human meme, word to Jah, Young Aaron, the racist provocateur, Henrik Budcross, Nelson Bangdella, Sergio Can't See Me, Vladimir Buffin, the human word is melting in your mouth, Mr. Bex on Decatur, Ricky Ticket Squabby, Greg Popovich, Morris Sayers, Richard Chestnut, Mahatma Gandhi, not Maccabee, but I got that cucumber, the juice suppressed, but your boy never is. I am the art, damn it, the Dundada Ganoush, normal cup of noodles, the Prince of Peckham, the Fashion Nova Casanova, William 8 cent, 5 cent, 10 cent dollar, forget small change.
Whoa,
big money wine. The only anthem I salute is Dipset. Mr. Sacker, catch me at square one, top left. Chill Rizzuto, holy cow. Mr. Soft Uncle, all I do is count checks and jerk off. We got OJ, Purple Cell Soda, and it's me, Sunny D.
Yeah.
David Yerman, these are expensive, these are red bottles, these are bloody shoes. Smokeem Noah, ooh. Andrew Kuhn, Nanny, a.k.a. the Junior, Andy God Jr., come sit down, palm me charger. Call me Petco, because I got your bitch on freeze. And remember, people, if Petco is clean, checking your animals and clean them, be sure to keep an eye on them, because they killed that lady's dog on Twitter, and it's very sad. I don't have more information, but Google. The topic of gossip and siasset, shout out to the 1191, A.K.A. Grandpa Joku, you see Charlie, you see me, don't touch that golden ticker. You get scratched. Damn. Your man, Dead Eye Desus, morning, Sheriff. Hmm. Be a real shame if, I don't know, I ordered food and didn't pick it up. Or even more, when you come to the front door of your store and you're like, hey, picking up from Mike, and I say, I'm Mike, and I'm not Mike. And now, listen, you gotta take another meal. It's not really
shopping. Wow.
But it is. Mr. Formerly shopping at Streety with the bad breezes like I'm Yeezy, please believe me. The Black Asian Attic will crack your back at a Codomatic, Craftmatic, Mr. La Marina, and Mesh Marina with a fresh misdemeanor and a cold demeanor. Listen, we're still jumping Mr. Rogers. So,
yeah.
Mr. Rogers' neighborhood. Listen, we're not done. We're coming back to land of make-believe. We're not done.
We're coming for our corners.
Okay. It's the Sheet Mask Killer, Illa. No one could be Illa. The Black Zach Morse, Support Morse, Young KPI. It's your man, Personal DJ, Kedapele, a Peloton. JPI, Queso. Inspector Terror Deck. Nickelbag, Star Cozy. Yes. James Vaxton, aka your Problematic Bay. Listen, it's not a secret family if you only vaccinate half of them.
That's true.
Listen, may the reward go to the survivors.
You know what I'm saying?
Up next, we got. Coming to the table, it's the kid Mero.
Yes, right, baby. It's your boy, the kid Mero, aka the human durag, aka Donovan McJab, aka Curve Gotti, aka Tris Khalifa. You know what I'm saying? Aka Skirt. Load a jump the curb, beat your motherfucking dog, and keep moving. Ask me if I give a fuck. The leash was less than 6 feet long. Stupid. We're observing social distancing across all species. Okay? I'm no fucking baby, I'm fucking man, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? I don't need to check the guest list because. There is no guest list, dog. It's very limited capacity, so yeah. Sorry. You're not there. I am. Sorry.
And KCC, dab out here, you know what I'm saying? Catch me in my basement doing highly concentrated hits of THC on the weekend, baby. Get right. I'm saying? And it's because I'm washed. I wish I smoked weed to be cool. And wouldn't it be cool? Wouldn't it be cool to smoke weed to be cool and not because you're washed and your back hurts? Damn. Those were the days. You know what I'm saying? AKA Tiger Backwoods, smoking 3 gram blood, and hit you with this 9 iron. AKA getting to the shmoney and the smoke. It's your boy Goldman Schmack. AKA Mesh Montana, huh? I went from Roach Motels like the Capri to Koi Ponds next to the putting green. I think I did pretty well for myself. AKA I got my motherfucking kids declaring for the NBA draft next year because they're all going to be on the motherfucking New York Knickerbockers, the New York team. You know what I'm saying? The number one New York basketball organization. I said it. You know what I'm saying? Number two, 1A and 1B, Knicks, Liberty. Everybody else get the fuck out of here. You know what I'm saying? I said it. You know what I'm saying? Gospel. You know what I'm saying? AKA Ben Smack Biombo. You know what I'm saying? AKA Diego Maradona. You know what I'm saying? AKA Dick in your baby. You don't come with this pussy no more. This pussy belongs to me. Actually, it does not. It belongs to you, my queen, and I request entry at your earliest convenience. Thank you. Because I need to respect your agency. Thank you. Thank you. AKA Bottles Antenna. So smooth. I fall asleep at the wheel and crash a zip car. You know what I'm saying? AKA the Dominican daddy, you know what I'm saying? Catch me up there. You know what I mean? AKA, I'm going to swipe my card again. There's definitely money on the fucking card. Stop trying to play me before I call your manager that comes out here every single fucking time this happens. And it's like, oh my God, I loved the last episode of the show. So just swipe the fucking shit and put the fucking donuts in the bag, dog. I got to go now. You know what I'm saying? This edible's hit kicking in, and the old lady in front of me is just trying to freak me out. You know what I'm saying? AKA Romeo Santos, tu favorito, mami, so zany. Let me black out. You know what I'm saying? Becoming fuerte en junio, papi. That's right. You know what I'm saying? La historia de la bachata. You know what I'm saying? AKA Lightning El Dutchie. Hello. Is it weed you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. That you been around a fire, so I cannot share this blood with you. You know what I'm saying? AKA Tom Brazier, got my balls more deflated than Bobby Kraft. AKA Field Dance Tyson, I want to explore your cosmos by consensually, of course. AKA Los Snoozy Vert, first nigga to tap out on live, big social distance pre-Rona. AKA Fernando Messi, MVP of Gelato. AKA Zaniel Bettyfield, I gotta get some sticks. I gotta get some sticks. AKA Joe Hookah. I dare you
to what?
To smoke with me at Mama Sushi. You know what I'm saying? Because they opened at 120 capacity. You know what I'm saying? AKA, I'll open your medicine cabinet. You know who the fuck it is. It's your boy, the Zen Man. AKA Rico Sabroso. AKA Baby Nupo 25. Nigga, garbage down the way. AKA Nino Brown, shut the Carter down for privatization. AKA Dr. Hornell West, you know what I'm saying? If you're majoring in horny studies, holla at your boy. AKA live harassing patrons outside MSG, it's the East Stream on Stevie B, you know what I'm saying? Doing all his greatest hits like, I wanna be the one your TT is fucking, and don't take love, don't let me leave. You know what I'm saying? AKA I'm like princess, I'm never gonna fail, you know what I'm saying? AKA, there's only two rock stars left in the world, babe. The Bodega Boys. Whew. Of which I am one. The plantain seeping over in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on Dreamer. Looking at you disapprovingly for not bringing them back. You know what I'm saying? AKA back at it, blazing trails, and that runs pack trying to make the play-in tournament. It's Barmelo's Anthony. Hey. Bang! You love to see it. Yo, listen. Yo, if you see me at Target higher than the current sea levels due to global warming, approach me like a motherfucker Ursine mammal nuclear. You know what I'm saying? Because I might react erratically, and you won't like that because I got claws. You know what I'm saying? Stay away from my cubs. You know what I mean? AKA Tom Petty and the Ball Breakers, baby, because we still zooming and I'm still free. Free bowling. I'm just letting them hang. You know what I'm saying? I saw Fake Lean to your favorite SoundCloud rapper. He's high off whatever the ass of the Gatorade is left in my refrigerator. And it's not even in the refrigerator. It's on the floor in the garage. I'm just mixing it up with paint thinner now at this point. Ha, stupid. You know what I'm saying? AKA. Hey, guys. Everything's back open again. So we're live in your crib. It's Mr. Fun Fun and Benzo the Clown, ladies and gentlemen. We're here. And can I get that 500 up front real quick? I'm just going to go count it. And while I count it, Mr. Fun Fun will have some fun time with your kids.
Hey, kids. Mr. Fun Fun here. Just questions. Before I get close to you, can I just see your vaccination cards? Also, if you have, like, I don't know, a card to make sure, you know, you're not, like, over the age of 12, because, you know what I'm saying? I don't really deal with elderly people.
So. Mr. Frontrun, we got the money. We got the money. We can go. Bye.
My kids at the Madison Beer concert. Yeah.
Whoa. Okay, let's go. Let's get in the minivan. Let's go. Oh, skirt. Primeramente, shout out Colombia, todo mi gente activo en Colombia. Libertad, fuerza, Colombia. Hasan, tíreme la pista, coño. Oye, que lo que voy a jugar. Llegó el instituto de FIFA, coño. El malo con todo, bajando con la pámpara prendida, coño, truchísimo. No me descontrola, coño, que paro que tiene Tito, te tumba el coco, mamá huevo. No te haga. No sé. Estamos Tivini en Diamond, loco, en el Tigre. Tú me vas a ver en el Tigre con un humazo, loco, con una juca electrónica, una banda del futuro, coño. Cacao Ñema, con vacinilla, acabando con todo, loco. Como te dije la semana pasada, coño, yo tengo más cadena que una fábrica de fucking bicicleta, loco. No te, tírate si tú eres guapo, coño, que te exploto. Te desguabino, coño, como un mango podrido. Atrévete. ¿Ok? You know what I'm saying? Shout out. Primeramente, shout out Showtime, la casa. Shout out Cash App, el patrocinador. Shout out Hasan Insane, el que pone la fucking nota. Shout out Desus One, la nota jamaiquina, coño, el más duro. Shout out Victor Marte, el papi de la lady, coño, que se hizo un, lo que le dicen los gringos, un little trim, pero todavía está más duro que el diablo. Se me está parando el huevo solo mirándolo en el Zoom. You know what I'm saying? Shout out la nena de la bodega, coño. Dai, la más planta, la superable, coño, la más dura. Shout out mi presidente Pío. Secretaria de Defensa activo con gallón, avísame que lo suelto, mi loco. Llegó mi no este friki, loco, yo no lo voy a dejar de decir. 12 años por no ser boca flojo, yo no hago coro ocupar lomo ni chivate, ni gente que chivatea. Todo el mundo de este lado está sólido. Tenlo claro. Que descanse para mi maldito sexo y mi hermano Chawi. Que entra a la casa, lávate tu fucking mano, ponte tu máscara, a toda la vaina bien. Y mamá, todo está bien, dijo el CDC. Vamos a comer culo. 2021, tú sabes que lo que me quité. Ya. 242, let's go, papá.
So, 242, the world's most dangerous podcast. You know the fucking vibes. As always, shout out to Square Cash. Shout out to Showtime. We still have a hiatus and enjoying that sweet bitch. And you know the fucking vibes. Yo, we'll be back when we back. Make sure the pandemic's still alive, still happening. Make sure you don't do stupid and die before 243. And if you do, hey, enjoy this podcast.
Yeah. Pearly Gates. You know what I'm saying? Remember. Enjoy.
When God asks you what brings you here, be like, bro, I'm a sushi boy. Don't watch the video with people online. You know the fucking vibes. Yo. Also, remember, if you die, when they show your life at the pearly gates, everyone online behind you is going to see every porn clip you ever watched.
You ever watched,
so when
ever
you
in
bust
life.
Your nut tonight, you do it with gusto. And you do it the best way you can so that That's when you get up there, they be like, yo, bro, he got a strong cock.
Yeah.
And that's the lesson for tonight. When you go out with a strong cock.
Go out with a strong cock. Holla.
We out. People be like, yo, happy birthday, Desus. I'll be like, what the fuck? I'll be like, it's not our birthdays. What the fuck is wrong with you? What are you, the cops? What you out here giving out personal information? The fuck is wrong with you? I don't got no birthday, nigga.
How? Nigga, talk to me, bro. What is it? You all this?
Nigga, you think when my parents came here from Jamaica, you think they had birthday money? Huh? My mother haven't had me in the back of Golden Crust silently on her lunch shift. She had the pad door crying. With hard-o bread. It was sad.